It's a seemingly endless string of videos of young thugs running riot across the state. And while the government defends its policies, today we learned more about one of the victims, an innocent, friendly photographer who will never recover after a sickening attack at a Toowoomba taxi rank.
75-year-old Robert Brown, a photographer with a passion for telling people's stories.
He represented some of the best of what we are as people. He would give his time to anyone in the community.
His own story now tragically linked to the state's youth crime crisis. The Toowoomba local was out shopping on Monday when it's alleged a teen robbed and assaulted him, his injuries not survivable.
We're seeking, you know, the government to do something about this. It's not just Robert as the latest crime, it's all of these crimes that we hear about daily.
Five teenagers have been linked with the crime, the latest number of a growing list of child offenders.
They are costing Queenslanders their lives, and they are costing Queenslanders the feeling of safety.
The Premier back in Brisbane today talking renewable energy at a biscuit factory.
My favourite, Monte Carlo or Kingston.
But the youth crime crisis looming as an unsavoury issue for Parliament's return. Car thefts, record highs. High profile crimes committed regularly, forcing new laws from the government.
There are some very complex issues here, as you can appreciate.
The details of the legislative reform haven't been released. The Premier maintaining they'll be introduced first and consulted on second.
Our efforts are now focused in targeting that 10%, those serious repeat offenders.
Keeping Queenslanders on edge. Joel Dreyer, 7 News.